Today, on Be Something Wonderful, How to Forgive and Forget the Neville Goddard Way. I am your host, Tom Karen, and this is the Be Something Wonderful studio of Higher Consciousness, where we help you level up and become the best version of yourself. Creators, welcome back. I want to talk about forgiveness today. What did Neville talk about forgiveness? Neville talks about a distinguishing between the eternal human that occupies a state and the state itself. Right? Because all states exist, all mansions of God exist, right? Whatever we can imagine, believe, and occupy, we can be. When you distinguish between the eternal human and the state itself, you can forgive that human because it's just the state they're occupying, right? And then furthermore, you can forget. What is the forgetting part? Forgetting is forgetting that lower state, forgetting who you were, forgetting that state that's not your higher ideal. If you persistently occupy that higher ideal, if you persuade yourself you are that person that you want to be, then you forget that other state. That not only applies to you, it applies to others. Seeing others as the ideal, as you would want them to see. Once you persuade yourself that you can do that, you forget. That's true forgiveness. This is what Neville talked about. True forgiveness is forgetfulness, right? This idea that, and he also talked about the continual forgiveness of sin. What is that? That's always continually aspiring to that higher ideal, that new idea of yourself, what you, your current wish or what you want to have in your life. And it goes back to the Bible when Simon Peter asked Jesus, Father, how often should I forgive my brother who has sinned against me? 70? And Jesus said, no, that's not what I said to you, Peter. 70 times 7. What does that mean? It means continual forgiveness of sin, or continually seeing your brother or others or yourself as that higher ideal in that desired state. That's big. That's forgiveness. Forgetting the apparent sins that they have made, right? Because those don't really exist. Only the new state, right? That other state is forgotten. This is what A Course in Miracles talks about too. That in the 3D world, sin can exist to us in the 3D world, but in the eternal state in heaven, in that in the kingdom of heaven, sin does not exist. True forgiveness is that bridge. Saying that it was an error. It was an error in perception. It was an error in your thinking. It was an error in you imagining that you're something else than who you really are. Right? That's forgiveness. It's remembering, hear this, this is big. It's remembering who you really are. Remembering that higher ideal, that higher, more loving you. That's big. That's forgiveness. And so, and then Jesus said it, right? Father, forgive them, for they know. For they do not know what they do. They do not know what they do. Why? Because they're occupying a state. They're eternal. The eternal human does not, if you're in a state and you're not aware of that state, you don't know what you're doing. You don't know that you can be that higher ideal. You don't know you can imagine. So Jesus, it was unconditional forgiveness. That's what repentance is. That's when you repent, right? You repent by seeing that higher ideal, by seeing yourself as that higher, greater, wiser you. That's big, guys. 70 times 7. That's what we're talking about. So this is forgiveness and forgetfulness, what Neville Goddard was talking about. He also talked about the art of revision. And we'll talk more about this. We've talked about revision, and he called it the pruning shears of revision, where if there was something in the past, even as recent as yesterday, that you would like to be different, then you can revise it. Where do you revise it? It's a mental activity. It's a mental action in your imagination. You revise it how you would have wanted it to be. Then you are erasing that past. You're actually changing the past, and this affects your present and what you're attracting in the present. This is revision. We'll talk more about this, but it's experiencing in imagination what you wish to experience, which you wish you experienced in the flesh. It's revising what happened to what you wish would have happened. That's big. That's also forgiveness and forgetfulness. I am your host, Tom Karen, and this is the Be Something Wonderful studio of Higher Consciousness, where we help you level up and become the best version of yourself. Guys, don't forget to subscribe, hit the notification button, like and share our videos. That's how we get our message out. Visit us on Facebook at Be Something Wonderful, on Instagram and Twitter at Tom Kieran, our websites at TomKieran.com or BeSomethingWonderful.com. Write me at info@BeSomethingWonderful.com. I would love to hear from you. Until next time, with great love, this is Tom. See you soon.